Hello everyone. Today we are going to discuss another topic, that is local search algorithms. So what exactly local search algorithm is, that we will cover today in this today's lecture. Now before going into this, we will discuss or we will take a review of what we covered in the previous lectures. In the previous lecture we started with informed search strategies, and we found that it is also called as heuristic search algorithms or heuristic search strategy. There are two major categories or major types of such algorithms. First one is best first search, which is also called as greedy search. And we found that in that particular algorithm, the important formula which we use to solve the given problem is this: evaluation function is equal to heuristic value or heuristic function, which is nothing but an estimated cost for a node n to reach to the goal node. What is the estimated cost? Estimated means determined or predicted cost for any node n. For any node, this n node can be a node, b node, c node, any node in the search tree. In the search tree, you know there are number of nodes. So for if I want to find out if there is a node, and if I want to find out heuristic function for a node, so I will denote it in this fashion, h of a. So h of a is nothing but estimated cost for node a to reach to the goal node. Estimated means predicted or determined, or you can say calculated. Okay, not actual, it is not actual, but it is estimated, it is predicted value. So best first search uses this particular formula, which is based on estimated cost, heuristic cost of any node. So this algorithm we discussed already, and we mentioned that in this algorithm we always keep two lists, open list and closed list. Open list contains all those nodes which are not expanded, not explored, not traversed. And closed list always maintains which nodes? It keeps which nodes? It keeps all those nodes in the search tree which are traversed or which are expanded or which are explored. Okay, so this problem we took in the given problem, search tree was given, and this heuristic cost of each of the node in the search tree was given, and our objective was to reach the goal node. We want to find out the optimal path out of these various paths in the search tree. We start with the root node and we want to reach to the goal node from these various paths based on the heuristic cost. Okay, and it is found that we solved this problem in this manner. We noted down here the heuristic cost of each node. Here A node is not explored, B node is explored into its successors, and we maintain this in this fashion. The solution is maintained or written in this fashion: initialization, iteration 1, 2, 3, and at the end we get the solution. So detailed video is prepared on this particular topic of best first search. Performance measures as well as disadvantages also we noted down. What were the disadvantages? It does not guarantee to reach the goal state. This is very dominant disadvantage. Since it is a greedy approach, that why it is greedy? Because it always calculates at each current state. If the current state has two successor node, which of the successor node has low cost? Okay, then our algorithm always follows the low cost path. That means it is greedy in nature. It do not follow the high cost path, high cost node. It will not expand, it will not explore the high cost node. It will always explore the low cost node. That's why it is a greedy approach. And doing the greedy approach, sometimes it will not get an optimized solution. Okay, for example, suppose we have not explored node A, but it may happen that after certain points, after certain nodes, you may get the goal node like this. Suppose here is also a one path to reach to the goal node. This is also one path to reach to the goal node, and this is also one path. So you may find that the heuristic cost of node B is 4 and heuristic cost of node A is 12, even though at this particular stage we will select this particular node B as compared to node A, but later on you may find that sometimes the heuristic cost of the next nodes are less as compared to the heuristic cost of these nodes. So sometimes even though we rejected this particular path, but later on at the end we will find, or we will understand that if we had followed this path, then the total cost of following this path would be less than this. Sometimes it may happen like this. So that's why it is mentioned that due to greedy approach, sometimes this algorithm do not give the optimized solution, and it covers a long distance. The next algorithm also we discuss, that is A star algorithm, and we noted down that this algorithm can be solved or can be executed with the help of this formula. And in the previous lecture in detail we discussed what exactly this evaluation function formula is. In the greedy search algorithm, the greedy search algorithm is based on only this formula, but in case of A star search, this additional information is also added in the formula of f of n. F of n is the evaluation function of any node n. This n node can be A node, B node, C node, and so on. Then we also discussed this particular problem wherein we maintained open list, closed list, and we solved this problem to get a final solution SACG with a cost 6, and this cost was very less as compared to the remaining path cost. The major disadvantage of this algorithm was it mostly runs out of space for a long period. Then today we are going to cover this particular next topic, that is local search algorithm. What exactly it is, we will discuss. The informed and uninformed search algorithms always expands the nodes systematically. Systematically means in two ways. It always, such algorithms always keeps different paths in the memory. Okay, it keeps all the paths in the memory, evaluate the heuristic functions, evaluation functions, and then decide by which path we need to go. Okay, and for that a huge memory is required. And then out of all the paths, it select the best suitable path, which is optimal path. It tries to select the optimal path. Both the category algorithm tries to select optimal path out of all the paths. But beyond these classical search algorithm, these two are the classical search algorithm categories, we have some local search algorithm as well, wherein path cost does not matter. Path cost are not so important. Those algorithms, such local search algorithm, always focus on solution state needed to reach the goal node. That means current state. Okay, local search algorithm completes its task by traversing on a single current node. Single is a very important, rather than multiple paths at a time. It only concentrate on single current state or current node, single node. Okay, in the search tree, following the neighbors of that node generally. Although local search algorithms are not systematic as compared to these two, they have the following two advantages. Which are those two advantages? Local search algorithms uses very little or constant amount of memory. Very little memory it requires, because it do not concentrate on multiple paths. It concentrate on only single current state, current node. Where exactly the algorithm is, where exactly the agent is, what is the current situation, what is the current node. That's why the memory requirement is very less as compared to the classical algorithms. Most often they find a reasonable solution in large or infinite state spaces where the classical algorithms do not work. This is the advantage of local search algorithms. In order to understand the local search algorithm, their working, we need to consider the state space diagram. In the state space diagram, you find that there is x-axis, which is nothing but a state space. For example, this is your start node, initial state or initial node, and this is your goal node. In between these two, there can be number of intermediate nodes or intermediate states like this. So x-axis in the state space diagram is always the state space or location. On the y-axis, where you will find there can be objective function. If it is an objective function, then our target is always to achieve the maximum value, highest value in this diagram. If the y-axis is a cost function, then we know that cost must be as small as possible. So our task of our algorithm is always to find the minimum values in these terrains, in these paths, along these paths, along these hills. So this is what the state space diagram is. Local search algorithms explores above landscape, above state space diagram, by finding the following 2 points. Which are those 2 points? Global maximum and global maximum. Sorry, global max minimum, minimum and global maximum. Where is the global maximum here? This is global maximum. This is local maximum. Local maximum is also a peak point, but it is lower than this. And it is, why it is local maximum? Because it is higher than the neighboring positions. Okay, that's why it is a local maximum. And global maximum means, out of all the state space, it is the highest point of maximum height. That's why it is a global maximum. It is a local maximum. It is a shoulder. This is a flat area. It is called as shoulder, which we will cover in the next slides to come. And this is called as plateau. It is also a flat area wherein you don't find any ups and downs. So if your y-axis means elevation corresponds to the cost, then the local search algorithm always find the lowest value, lowest value, which is known as global minimum. If the y-axis elevation corresponds to objective function, then our task is to always find the highest peak on the mountain, in the mountain. That is called as global maximum. Okay, there are 3 types of local search algorithms: hill climbing, simulated annealing, and local beam search. One important note here is, these algorithms do not burden to remember all the nodes in the memory. So memory requirement is very less. It only operates on the current state and current position or current node or intermediate node where it is. The first category, hill climbing algorithm. As usual, it is a local search algorithm. As explained in the previous slide, it is local search algorithm. Its purpose is, the purpose of hill climbing search is to climb a hill and reach the topmost peak or point of that hill. This is very important. You have to remember this. It is based on heuristic search technique, where person who is climbing, that means climber, the person who is climbing up on the hill estimates, this is very important word, estimates the direction. So climber always want direction, whether to move ahead or move backward. Okay, because we want, ultimately we want what? Topmost point. So when you are climbing on a hill, the climber always wants the direction, decides the direction, estimates the direction, whether to move ahead or go back, okay, to reach the highest peak. That means it continuously moves up in the direction increasing elevation. It continuously moves in the direction of increasing elevation or value to find the peak of the mountain. Peak of the mountain is nothing but, in our AI domain, it is called as best solution of the problem. It terminates when it reaches the peak. It stops searching when you get the peak, where no neighbor has a higher value than that peak. Okay, it is called greedy local search, as it only looks to its good immediate neighbor. It compares the current position with only immediate neighbors, not to the farthest neighbors, farthest points or farthest states. That's why it is called as greedy local search. A node in this algorithm has two components, state and value. It is mostly used when good heuristic is available. In this algorithm, we don't need to maintain and handle the search tree or graph. It only keeps the single current state. This point also makes some difference between local search and classical search, informed and uninformed. In classical search algorithm, we always require search tree. But here in local search, we don't require search tree. It works only on single current state. That's why in the memory, there is no need to maintain the search tree. Only single current state is required to be maintained in the memory. That's why it is a memory efficient. Example of this algorithm is traveling salesman problem, where the objective is to minimize the distance traveled by the salesman. For example, traveling salesman is moving in our city, and the target is to cover all the colonies of our city, okay, and to sell the maximum products. But the objective is he should cover all the colonies with minimum distance. That means total distance covered by the salesman should be as small as possible, provided that the salesman has covered all the colonies of our city so as to sell the products. So this is a traveling salesman problem which comes under this local hill climbing problem search. To understand the hill climbing algorithm, we need to consider state space diagram, which we already observed in the previous slide. Let us check again here. Okay, so this is a state space diagram. What exactly it is? State space diagram is a graphical representation of hill climbing algorithm, which is showing graph between what? Various states of algorithm and objective function or cost. States on x-axis, objective function or cost on y-axis, which we discussed in the previous diagram here. State space versus objective function versus or cost. On y-axis, if we take objective function, y-axis we can take objective function or cost function. If on y-axis there is cost function, then goal of the local search, objective of the local search is to find the global minimum and local minimum if there is cost on y-axis. If there is an objective function you consider on y-axis, then objective of this algorithm is to find global maximum and local maximum, because objective function must be maximized. This is the role of our algorithm. If we check this diagram, let me show it in a clear manner. This same diagram, here is a shoulder, global maximum, local maximum, flat area. Okay, this is current state. That means climber can move like this. Climber goes here, then goes down, again moves up, moves down like this. Sometimes the climber is somewhere here, sometimes the climber is in a shoulder region, sometimes the climber means a person who climbs up, reaches the topmost position, lowest position, like this. So global maximum, you understood, it is the highest point on the hill. Local maximum, it is the peak higher than all the local maximum, it is a peak higher than all the neighboring peaks, but it is not higher than global maximum, it is lower than global maximum. Flat local maximum, it is the flat area over the hill where it has no uphill or downhill. This is the flat local maximum area. Shoulder, it is also a flat area where the summit is possible. Current state means it is the current position of the person. There are three types of hill climbing algorithm: simple hill climbing, steepest ascent hill climbing, stochastic hill climbing. So let us go through the algorithm of simple hill climbing algorithm. It is very simple to understand. Step 1, create current node and neighbor node and goal node. Three nodes are created in step number 1. Step number 2, check if the current node is a goal node, then return goal and terminate the search. Stop the search because we obtained the goal. We obtained the goal means we obtained the maximum point, we obtained the global maximum. Else, if the current node is less than or equal to neighbor node, if it is so, if the current position is lower, is of lower height than peak, then move ahead. And step 4, loop until the goal is not reached or point is not found. So this is the working of simple hill climbing. Steepest ascent hill climbing, unlike the above, it considers all the successive nodes and compares, this word is very important, it compares them and choose the node which is closest to the solution. It is similar to best first search because it focuses on each node instead of one. Algorithm is somewhat like this. Step 1, create current node, goal node as well as neighbor node. If the current node is equal to goal node, then return the goal, terminate the search. Step 3, loop until better node is not found, better than the current node, to reach the solution. If there is any better successor node present, then expand it or explore it, or you can say traverse it. When the goal is attained, then return the goal and terminate the process, search process. Even though the hill climbing algorithm is fast as well as furious, it works very rapidly to find the solution, but there are some limitations. For example, it may get stuck in local maxima. Suppose the climber is somewhere here and it climbs the hills, he climbs the hills like this in this direction. Every time it checks whether the next position is better than the current position, then he moves up. He does the same comparison each time. Once he reaches here, then he finds, he compares this position with the neighboring position, this as well as this, and he finds that he achieved the maximum point and he stops searching now because he assumes that he obtained the global maximum, but exactly it is, but in reality it is a local maximum because global maximum is somewhere here. So this is the disadvantage or limitation of hill climbing algorithm. Second limitation is if the climber is in this particular area, plateau area, it is difficult for the climber now in this area to decide in which direction he should move to reach the goal point. Your goal point is somewhere here and your climber is somewhere here, for example. So in this flat area, the climber do not understand whether to move backward or to move forward because the area is very flat and he do not get the direction. So this is also one limitation of this algorithm. And third limitation is if the climber faces such a regions where sharp ridges are there and all ridges are of same height. So climber, the person finds two or more local maxima of the same height, it becomes difficult for the person to navigate or to find the direction. Okay. So that he can reach the destination or goal node or the maximum, global maximum. Other two categories of local search algorithms are this. We discussed up till now, we discussed first category of local search, that is hill climbing. Second category is simulated annealing. Third is local beam search. This algorithm is similar to hill climbing. It works on the current situation. It picks the random, but it picks the random move instead of picking the best move. If the move leads to the improvement than the current situation, then it is always accepted. as a step towards the solution state. So it always compares the, it randomly takes the move action, and if it is better than the current situation, then it accepts, otherwise it rejects and go on searching further. This technique was first used in 1980 to solve VLSI layout problems, factory scheduling, as well as in other optimization tasks. Third category is, in this local search algorithm, is local beam search. It keeps track of k states, this is very important, instead of just one state. State means node, okay, nodes, intermediate nodes, and our objective is to reach the goal node or goal state. So it keeps the track of k states simultaneously. It select k randomly generated states, randomly generated, this word is very important. This is also a random move. These random moves are not in hill climbing algorithm. Random moves are in simulated annealing and local beam. Otherwise, rest of the things are same. The concept is same. Expand them randomly. It select k randomly generated states, expand them at each step. If any state is goal state, then the search stops with success. Success is obtained, means goal node is obtained. Else it selects the best k successors. Out of remaining successors, best k successors are selected from the complete list and repeats the same process. That means which process? Expand them at each step, compare them and find out the best out of them. Okay, so this is what the local beam search is. So this is what, in this way we studied the local search algorithms. Three categories we searched, we discussed what exactly local search algorithm is, how they are different from informed and uninformed search, that means classical search algorithms. We discussed what exactly state space diagram is, various regions also we understood, and we discussed there are three types of local search algorithms: hill climbing, simulated annealing and local beam search. We discussed in detail the hill climbing algorithm, and we discussed this particular diagram, discussed three types of hill climbing, their algorithms. We also discussed the limitations of hill climbing, that are local maxima, plateau and ridges. And then we, at the end, we discussed simulated annealing and local beam search concepts. In the next lectures to come, we will discuss these important differences: strong AI versus weak AI, uninformed search versus informed search, BFS versus DFS. And later on, we will cover online search agent. This particular point we will cover. So today we will stop here. Thank you very much.